Okay, now I'm going to split the transmission. It has 9 of these bolts. They're a half inch. I'll go ahead and take all the bolts out. Now I'll go ahead and split the case. I'll get a screwdriver and put it between here. Try and pry it apart. That was pretty simple there. Came right apart. Go right around to here. Get the lift on up. Now let's see what we're into. Let's take this washer off. We gotta remember to put that back on there. Here's a seal. I gotta remember to put that back on there. It goes on there to keep water out of the where the belt's at. It's coming up quite easily. See what's holding it here. There it comes. Pull it straight up. Got this seal right here. Just kind of holding it a little bit. It's tight. Nice seal on there. Okay. There's nothing inside here. Okay, I'm gonna have to take it apart and take this out. I'm gonna take this off so I don't break it. This here is just your neutral, forward, and reverse indicator switch. Okay, now I'm going to go ahead and pull this rod of here out. Now I'm going to pull this piece right here out. Looks like your shifter. Oh yeah, this thing's wore down. That looks pretty bad right there. I don't think that's supposed to be like that. It's kind of got some grooves in it on both sides. Okay, now I got to get this out because it's got to be replaced. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to take that little clip off of it. Yeah, I think these things are too big. I didn't get a smaller pair. Came off. Okay, I'm going to take this bolt out. It's a 9/16. Okay, once you get this out, there's a spring on it. There's another little piece in here. And it looks to have a ball bearing on the other end. I'll pull that out and show you. So now I'll go ahead and take the washer off of this. Now I go ahead and push this out. Just push it inward. Give it a turn. Like so, and you should be able to just push it straight on out. Now this has got to be replaced. Now let's go in here. And it's not a ball. It's a, see if I can get this out. It's just like a small rod. If I had a magnet, which I do, I got a magnet right here. Here it is. I thought it was a ball bearing, but it's not a ball bearing. It's just a little, I don't know what it is, but it works really well. Don't have to worry about losing it like a ball bearing. Now to get the inside gears out, I got to take this sprocket off, which means I got to take this spring clamp off. Now I'll go ahead and take the sprocket off. Okay, now we got everything loose and coming out. Okay, and we'll see what everything is. Okay, all bearings. Bearings all sound and feel really good. So this should be all right. I don't see any missing teeth. Let's check our gears here. There's no missing teeth. The bearing feels and sounds good. Looks good. Okay. Okay. So this one sounds like. Feels and sounds good. Looks good. There's no missing teeth. Slider slides pretty good. See nothing in there. I don't see nothing in there that could be an issue. Okay, so we only need two parts. The chain is nice and tight, so there's no issue with the chain. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to order this, I'm going to order this, and I'm going to put it back together. I got my new parts, and I'll show them to you. But I want to put it all together and then drop it down in there. So I'll put that chain on. Now I'm going to stick this chain on this bottom gear right here. I'm going to make sure that these gears are all lined up. I'm just going to take it over here. I'm going to just drop it right down inside here. Okay. As you can see, everything just snapped in place. This is the new part. If you look at these little ridges right here where the shifter actually locks in, you'll see on this one that they're almost gone. Also, this one didn't come with an O-ring, so I'm going to have to use this O-ring. I'm going to go ahead and throw some grease around this. I'm going to go ahead and throw some grease on this bearing as well before I put it together. Now I'll go ahead and I'm going to slide this up in there and right out. There we go. Now I'm going to go ahead and put the washer on it. Now I'll go ahead and put the snap ring on. And if you look at the snap ring, you'll see it's flat on one side and kind of round on the other. So you want to put the flat side down. This is the parts I ordered: a shift shaft, a bullet shifting, a spring compression, and a shift fork. Now this is a new fork shift. Now if you look at the old one, you'll see how it's grooved and cut away on both sides. It's not supposed to be like that. It's supposed to be solid, just like this one here is. On both sides. Okay, now what you want to do to put this in, you got this piece right here, slides up and down. this fork should go right in between here. So slide it on in there, because that's what helps to shift up and down. Now what you want to do is you want to take this and push it down, and you want to put your little piece there just sticking out inside that shift shaft. Now go ahead and put your rod through there. Take this new billet. I'm going to put it in here. Nose first. I'll make sure it's seated here on a lobe. I want to shift it. There we go. It's set inside there. Okay. I'm going to take the new spring, dip it in some grease. I'm going to put it inside this. Now this is going to take a little bit of pressure, because you got to push on top of that. And you got to turn. Plus this is a new spring. So there it goes. It takes a little bit of force to put it in there. Once you got it going, it's good. Take a 9/16 wrench and tighten that down. As you can see here, they used a clear sealant. Goes all the way over on the inside. We'll set it down on here. We'll put it on these little tabs here. Trying to push it down. There we go. I'll go ahead and put the bolts in it and snug it down. I'll go ahead and put the waterproof seal on it. I'll put the washer back on. I'll turn it around. Now I'll go ahead and put the sprocket on, and I'll go ahead and put the snap ring on. Now I'll go ahead and put the shift indicator on there. It only goes on one way. You'll see a little notch right here. You'll see a little notch right there. Goes just like that. I'll go ahead and put my screws in there and tighten it down. Now I'm going to go ahead and fill it with oil. I'm putting 85 140 in it. When I put the gear oil in, I want it to be between these two marks right here. Okay, remember, in between these two marks right here is our safe area. Put it down in there. Make sure the transmission is level. Pull it back out, and we are in our safe zone, so we are good. I used almost this whole bottle, all but about almost 8 ounces of a 32 ounce bottle. Okay, I'm going to take this back over, put it in the Polaris. That'll be another video. Like, comment, subscribe, share with your friends. Thanks for watching.